Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. There is a dangerous mentality among many people that thinking, using one's mind to fathom the world and solve problems, is optional, or is only necessary for some people, such as intellectuals or individuals in high-paying professional occupations. In fact, thinking is essential and indispensable for everyone. That includes you. Our reason, our ability to accurately identify what exists and to determine how it may best be used to promote our lives and flourishing, is the only means we have of reliably surviving and improving our position. Blindly following orders, routines, or conventions may occasionally enable one to survive, if someone else did the thinking behind these external impositions correctly. But it just as often results in catastrophic failure. Every procedure, institution, and norm should be questioned using critical thinking, and every person should engage in such questioning. The result will be an improvement of societal institutions, their alignment with reason and good sense, and a vast improvement in efficiency, innovation, and happiness in all areas of human life. Always think, no one is above or beneath using his mind. And that, ladies and gentlemen, brings me to a central question. Why do I create these videos? In other words, what am I trying to achieve by doing this? Clearly, mine is not the most popular channel on YouTube. If you count simply the number of page views or video views that my channel receives. Nonetheless, I'm not trying to win any popularity contests. What I am trying to do is to encourage a mindset of intellectualism among all of you who take the time and watch my videos. Intellectualism is not the same as simply an academic mindset. It's not the same as studying for a course. It's not the same as writing a dissertation. It's far broader than that. It is about the pursuit of truth. It is about the willingness, and indeed the eagerness, to use one's mind to fathom reality and to create something better than the world we have as it stands right now. To solve age-old problems that have plagued the human condition ever since humans came to be. To solve the problems not just posed by nature, by inanimate forces, natural disasters, diseases, senescence, but also by other human beings who, for failure to properly use their mind, commit a host of petty inanities and grand atrocities that, put together, results in a colossal waste of life and colossal suffering for virtually everybody. It is time to put this to an end. We have progressed as a species quite considerably in the past 200 years. Ever since the Age of Enlightenment resulted in a more systematic pursuit of reason to improve the human condition, we have had a technological flourishing manifesting itself in the Industrial Revolution in the late 18th and 19th centuries, and followed by, of course, its extrapolation through the 20th century, but also other developments, the Information Revolution that occurred with the advent of computers and the internet, the Green Agricultural Revolution that catalyzed dramatic improvements in survival in many countries that allowed billions of people to become adequately fed for the first time. We need to carry these achievements forward, but in order to do that, we need to be up to the challenge. Our minds need to be of a sufficiently high caliber and of sufficient creativity to be able to look at the world using reason and form fresh insights, not just to accept what we have been given or what has been indoctrinated into us. I want to make this plea to all of my viewers, no matter what their backgrounds, no matter what their ages, no matter what their occupations. To try to do something original in your work, whatever your work may be, to try to look at your field of endeavor and see how you personally can make a novel contribution to it. This is not a typical way in which people are taught to approach the world. Often people are taught to internalize certain patterns of behavior, starting in school, where people are taught to sit in desks, listen to the instructor, repeat back what the instructor tells them. And this approach of confusing learning with rote regurgitation and following orders imposed by an external authority tends to corrupt learning in the minds of people. Learning becomes associated with this kind of externally imposed discipline, and people tend to shy away from learning. It seems to me this is the principal cause of anti-intellectualism in many parts of the world. It is a glaring phenomenon in the United States, and one that needs to be overcome if we are to stave off the complete collapse of this country's economy and culture. So, ladies and gentlemen, the only way we can stave off that collapse is if you become a part of the solution. I'm not trying to get millions of page views with my videos, but I hope that with my videos, I can inspire at least a handful of individuals to rise to this next level of intellectualism and to go beyond my videos into a comprehensive search for truth, utilizing this vast ocean of information that we have in the form of the internet. Feel free to go out and explore and form connections and even bring them back here to this channel, into the discussions that you have in the comments that you post on my videos. Because that is what they are here for. They are not meant so much for an extensive exposure of ideas. Probably some sort of hip-hop music video would have orders of magnitude more views than my videos would. What they are meant is for an intensive development of the people who want to take up this challenge of advancing our civilization and becoming true intellectuals, becoming true Renaissance men that use their reasoning, their critical thinking, and their enthusiasm to form connections among disciplines that haven't been as well connected as they ought to be, and thereby to build novel insights that could carry our civilization forward and improve all of our lives. Thank you very much.